Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the Blazor Date Picker component from Syncfusion. On most websites, you have probably seen a date picker like this where you can select the desired date from a pop-up calendar and the selected date will be displayed. In this video, I'll explain you how easy it is to add a Syncfusion Blazor Date Picker component to a server-side based application. I will also show you how to configure a few of its basic features like specific date range values, formats, and different views such as month, year, and decade. Let me start with the application creation process. I can create a Blazor application using either Visual Studio 2019 or Visual Studio Code. In this video, I'll show you how to create a server-side Blazor application using Visual Studio 2019. Make sure that you have installed it along with .NET Core SDK 3.1.2 or later. Now open Visual Studio 2019 and choose Create a new project from the dashboard. Select Blazor app from the templates and click the Next button. Here I'll name my project and click the Create button. Here I will choose the Blazor server app. The project has been created and is ready to use. Now I will show you the step-by-step process for adding a Blazor date picker to it. To add and start using a Blazor date picker, first I need to install the necessary Syncfusion Blazor packages. For that, I'll open the NuGet package manager, I search for Syncfusion Blazor and install it into my application. Once it is installed, you can see the Blazor packages are added under the Applications Packages folder. Now to add a date picker, first, I'll navigate to the imports.razor page and import the namespace Syncfusion Blazor Calendars. Then I need to register the Syncfusion Blazor service. For that, I'll navigate to the startup.cs file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Next, I'll make a call to the Syncfusion Blazor service method inside the configure services method. And then within the configure method, I'll also register the Syncfusion license by passing the trial license key in the register license method. Next, I'll navigate to the host.cs HTML page to add a CSS reference from the installed Syncfusion Blazor package. Now, the configuration steps are done, so let me continue to add the Blazor date picker. For this, I will open the index component and here I will add the div element with the CSS styles to align the date picker component. And then I will include the SF date picker tag. Then I'm going to add a tValue property to specify the type of the component and set its value to date time. Now I will run my application by pressing FI key. You can see the output displaying the date picker. You can now select the date from the picker or enter a date value in the input box. Next, I will show you how to select a specific date value in the date picker using the value property. To do this, I will directly add the code inside the addCode directive. I will define a variable date value of type date time and assign some date value to it, say March 20, 2020. Now I will assign this variable to the value property of the date picker. See the output where the date value passed to the date picker's value property is displayed in the input box. Now, let me show you how to restrict the date value selection by setting the minimum and maximum date time value using the min and max properties. First, I will declare a public variable start value of type date time and set some start value, say March 10, 2020. Similarly, I will include an end value variable and set some end date value, say March 22, 2020. Now assign those values to the corresponding min and max properties of the date picker. See the output. Now I can only select the dates between March 10, 2020 and March 22, 2020. You can also see that the dates outside of the range are restricted from selection. Next, let me show you how to format the date displayed in the date picker. By default, the date picker's format is based on the culture. I can also set a custom format by using the format property. For that, I'm going to include the format property and set its value to custom format. You can notice here, when I select the date, it will be displayed in the given format. Finally, I will show you how to change and navigate between different views of the date picker. There are three types of date picker views: month, year, and decade. So far we have seen the default month view. Now I will change the view to decade by using the start property. Here I will include the start property and set its value to decade. You can see the date picker displaying the years of a decade. When I click a specific year in the date picker, it will show the list of months in the year, and on further clicking through any of the months, it will show the days of the selected month. You can also design the month range picker using the start and depth properties of date picker. Let me change the format property value to custom month year format and start property value to year, and then include the depth property and set its value to year. As you can see, the list of months displaying year, when I select any month from the date picker, it will be displayed in the input box. One more thing is, you can also show the short int in an input element of the date picker when no value is set to it. Here, I will add the placeholder property and assign the value choose a date. Now, see the output, the date picker shows the placeholder text. Now, let me summarize what we have seen so far. I have shown you how to create a Blazor Server app using Visual Studio 2019 and add a date picker component to it. And then I explained you how to configure the date picker with a specific date value and format. Finally, I have shown you the different date picker views, month, year, and decade, and how to design month range picker. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see about getting a free license key to use our Blazor products if you are eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.